Jonah and the huge fish. This is Jonah.
One day, long ago, God's word came to Jonah. Up on your feet and on your way to the big city of Nineveh. Preach to them they are in a bad way, and I can't ignore it any longer. But instead, Jonah got up and went down to port of Joppa and found a ship headed to Tarshish. He paid the fare and went on board. God sent a huge storm at the sea, the waves towering. The ship was about to break into pieces. The sailors were terrified. Meanwhile, Jonah had gone down into the hold of the ship to take a nap. He was sound asleep. The captain came to him and said, "Get up, pray to your God. Maybe your God will see you're in trouble and rescue us." When the sailors said to one another, let's get to the bottom of this. Let's just rush to identify who's responsible for this disaster. So they drew straws. Jonah got the short straw. Then they asked him, "Why this disaster? Where do you come from?" He told them, "I am a Hebrew. I worship God, the God of heaven who made sea and land." At that, the men were terrified, really terrified. As Jonah talked, the sailors realized that he was running away from God. They said to him, "What are we going to do with you to get rid of this storm?" Jonah said, "Throw me overboard into the sea. Get rid of me and you'll get rid of the storm." But no, the men tried rowing back to shore. The storm only got worse and worse, wild and raging. Then they took Jonah and threw him overboard. Immediately, the sea was quiet down. Then God assigned a huge fish to swallow Jonah. Jonah was in the fish belly 3 days and nights. Jonah prayed to his God from the belly of the fish. He prayed in trouble. Deep trouble, I prayed to God. He answered me, "I was as far down as a body can go, yet you pulled me up from that grave alive. Oh God, my God, when my life was slipping away, I remembered God, and my prayer got through you. I'm worshiping you, God, calling out in thanksgiving, and I'll do that, I promise." God spoke to the fish, and it vomited up Jonah on the seashore. The end.